Okay, for those of you who have joined today, I will just tell a brief summary of what was taught yesterday. So this chapter is about a young girl called Bholi. Her real name is Sulekha, but she is called Bholi because basically she is very simple hearted, very innocent girl. And her father is a revenue official, Nambardar. She belongs to a prosperous family, but Bholi is a very unfortunate child. When she is just 8 months old, one day accidentally she fell down from the cot, and due to that there was an injury in her brain, and she became a backward child. She learned to speak at a very late age. At the age of 5 years, she learned to speak. And also her speech was not clear. She used to stammer. So Bholi was very unfortunate age of 8 months. She had the brain injury due to which she lost her intelligence. She became a backward child. And again, when she was just 2 years old, she had smallpox. And due to that, there were black marks on her body. So she was a very neglected child because she had neither intelligence nor beauty. So at home also, she was a very neglected child. And the village in which she lived, a new school was opened in her village. It was a girls' school. And her father was asked to admit her in the school to set an example to the other villagers. So initially, Bholi's parents did not want to admit her to school. Why? Because as you know, in the villages, gender discrimination still prevails. So in Bholi's family also, the boys were sent to the city for education, but girls' education was not taken care of. But because Bholi's father was a government official, he had to admit his daughter to school. So Bholi ke father ka bahut man to nahi tha ki wo Bholi ko school mein admit karaye. Lekin because he was the revenue official, a government servant, so he had to admit his daughter in school. And as you can see in the picture, Bholi's father is taking her to school, and Bholi also has 6 other brothers and sisters. Bholi is the youngest in the family. Bholi is the youngest in the family, a very neglected child. Why is Bholi a neglected child? Because she has neither beauty nor brains. Bachpan mein jo hai, दो बहुत ही दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना हुई. एक तो 8 मंथ्स में भोली के सर में चोट लगा, जिसके कारण जो है उसका ब्रेन प्रॉपर फंक्शन नहीं करता था. फिर व्हेन शी वाज 2 इयर्स ओल्ड शी गॉट स्मॉल पॉक्स, बट आफ्टर द स्मॉल शी रिकवर्ड फ्रॉम द स्मॉल पॉक्स, बट द पॉक्स लेफ्ट द ब्लैक मार्क्स ऑन हर बॉडी. वो जो बड़ा सा ब्रिजल्स वाला जो पॉक्स होता है, उसमें जो है बहुत टाइम ऐसा होता है कि वो ठीक हो जाने पर भी मार्क्स रह जाते हैं. तो भोली के साथ भी ऐसा ही हुआ. सो दैट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट पॉक्स मार्क्स शी लॉस्ट हर ब्यूटी ऑल्सो, एंड शी वॉज नॉट एबल टू स्पीक क्लियरली. शी यूज टू स्टैमर, वो हकला के बोलती थी. बच्चे उसका मजाक उड़ाते थे, मिमिक करते थे. क्योंकि वो हकला के बोलती थी, तो वो उसने बोलना भी कम कर दिया क्योंकि नेचुरल है किसी अपना मजाक उड़ाना और उड़वाना किसी को अच्छा नहीं लगता है। तो भोली का भी सब मजाक उड़ाने लगे, तो शी स्टॉप्ड टॉकिंग, शी यूज्ड टू टॉक वेरी लेस एंड एट होम ऑल्सो शी वॉज अ निग्लेक्टेड चाइल्ड, शी वॉज जस्ट लाइक अ बर्डन फॉर हर पेरेंट्स एंड हर थ्री एल्डर सिस्टर्स दे वर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल थ्री एल्डर सिस्टर्स, शी हैड थ्री एल्डर सिस्टर्स एंड थ्री एल्डर ब्रदर्स ऑल्सो, शी बिलोंग टू अ प्रॉस्परस फार्मर्स फैमिली, फादर जो है वो प्रॉस्परस फार्मर है और छह भाई बहन है भोली के। एंड भोली इज द मोस्ट निग्लेक्टेड चाइल्ड बिकॉज शी इज नॉट इंटेलिजेंट एंड शी इज नॉट ब्यूटिफुल, हर अदर एल्डर थ्री सिस्टर्स दे आर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड पेरेंट्स थिंक दैट मैरिंग देयर थ्री एल्डर डॉटर्स विल बी वेरी ईजी टू फाइंड ब्राइड ग्रूम फॉर देम इज एन ईजी टास्क, बट दे वेर वरीड अबाउट भोली। सो देन अ प्राइमरी स्कूल इज ओपेंड इन द विलेज, गर्ल्स प्राइमरी स्कूल, गाँव में एक गर्ल्स प्राइमरी स्कूल खुला और जो स्कूल का इनॉग्रेशन करने आए गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल, उन्होंने भोली के फादर को कहा कि उनको अपने बेटी को स्कूल में पढ़ाना चाहिए टू सेट एन एग्जाम्पल, ही इज ऑल्सो अ गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल। सो भोली's फादर वॉज एडवाइज्ड टू एडमिट भोली टू स्कूल टू सेट एन एग्जाम्पल। सो इनिशियली पेरेंट्स आर हेजिटेंट, शुरू में जो है पेरेंट्स को बिल्कुल भी मन नहीं है कि भोली को स्कूल में डाले, लेकिन मजबूरी वश गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल गवर्नमेंट स्कूल है तो के लिए उन्होंने कंपल्शन, अंडर कंपल्शन दे पुट भोली इन द स्कूल एंड एज यू कैन सी द एक्सप्रेशन ऑन भोली's फेस, शी सो फ्राइड because when she is taken to school she thinks that her father is taking to sell her, kyunki ek din pehle hi unka jo purana cow tha Lakshmi, their old cow was sold because the old cow had become a burden for the family. So Bholi thought that everybody thinks of her as a burden, so they are taking to sell her like the old cow. That is why you can see the expression on her face. वो बहुत डरी हुई है हाँ, क्योंकि भोली को लगा कि उसके फादर जो हैं वो ओल्ड काउ के तरह उसको भी बेच देंगे, तो वो जोर से नो नो करके चिल्लाती है, she shouts no no, she shouted and father gets very angry. Father gets very angry. What is the matter with you, you fool? Shouted Ramlal. तब रामलाल ने भोली को समझाया कि वो उन्हें स्कूल ले जा रहे। I am taking you to school. And then for the first time, भोली is given clean clothes to wear. Hello, can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Voice is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, for the first time, you can just imagine Bholi's condition. Let her wear some clean clothes today. First time in her life, she's given clean clothes. Bholi ke kapde bhi nahi dhulte the. Ek to usko apne elder sisters ka chhoda hua kapda pehenna padta tha. Even those clothes were not washed or mended. Mended means stitched. अगर वो कहीं से फट गए तो उसको स्टिच भी नहीं किया जाता था, मतलब भोली को कैसा कपड़ा पहनने के लिए मिलता था घर में। She used to get the tattered and torn clothes which was left over by her elder sisters. So new clothes had been made for Bholi. The old dresses of her sisters were passed on to her. Till now she had never got a chance to wear a new dress. all the leftover old dresses of her sisters. She had to wear those dresses. No one cared to mend or wash. But today, Bholi was very fortunate that she was getting at least clean dress to wear. She was lucky to receive a clean dress which shrunk after many washings and no longer fitted Champa. Champa is her elder sister. And she is wearing her elder sister's leftover clothes because now those clothes don't fit her. It has shrunk. No longer fitted Champa. She even bathed and oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. And her hair was also very untidy, uncombed, tangled. And for the first time, mother was combing her hair because she thought that people will laugh at them. They were a prosperous and respectable family. So mother thought that at least Bholi is going outside. And if she was not in a good condition, then people would make fun of them. So she was even bathed and oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. Only then did she begin to believe that she was being taken to a place better than her home. And little by little, Bholi's fears vanished. Initially, she thought that her father was taking to sell her, just like the old cow Lakshmi. But when she was given clean clothes to wear, when mother combed and oiled her hair, then she began to believe that, no, they are not taking to sell her. They are taking her to a better place, to a place better than her home. So when they reached the school, the children were already in their classrooms. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress. So finally, Bholi and her father, they reached the school. The children were already in the classroom. The school had already started. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress. Left alone, the poor girl looked about her with fear-laden eyes. Now, Bholi had gone to school for the first time. It was a new place for her. And she did not know anybody in the school. It was her first day at school. She did not know anybody. It was a new place, a very strange place for her because she had hardly gone outside her house. So her eyes were full of fear, fear-laden eyes. And also, all the other children, they used to make fun of Bholi because she used to stammer. So they mimicked her and made fun of her. So maybe Bholi thought that in the school also the children will make fun of her. That is why there is fear in her eyes, fear-laden eyes. And she looked here and there with fear-laden eyes, with eyes full of fear. There were several rooms and in each room, girls like her squatted on the mats. It is a village. The children are sitting on the floor, on the mats. So Bholi looked around and she saw that in each of the rooms, there was children and they were sitting on the mats, reading from books or writing on slates. So some of the children were reading from the books and some of the children were writing on the slates. The headmistress asked one of the classrooms and she gave her a seat. She told her to sit in the corner in one of the classrooms. Bholi did not know what exactly a school was like and what happened there, but she was glad to find so many girls, almost of her own age, present there. So Bholi had gone to school for the first time. She did not know what a school was like, and she even did not know what was the purpose of going to school. As we know that she was a backward child, she even did not know why the children went to school, what happened there, what exactly a school was like and what happened there. But she was glad to find so many girls, almost of her own age, present there. But she was very happy to find that many girls of her age were present there. अब भोली कम से कम खुश थी, घर में तो उसको कोई वैल्यू ही नहीं देता था. यहाँ so many girls of her age and she was happy that at least there. Can you hear me? My voice is clear. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
She was glad to find so many girls almost of her own age present there. तो भोली को, भोली बैकवर्ड चाइल्ड थी, उसे ये भी नहीं पता था कि स्कूल लोग जाते क्यों हैं, स्कूल में क्या बच्चे Hello, can you hear? Hello? Hello, can you hear me? Reply karo.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Okay, these two pages are over. ये पेज तो नहीं था, ये पेज खत्म हो गया. So Bholi was happy. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls. So Bholi was given a classroom and she was happy that she was happy that so many girls, almost her own age, was present there.
She hoped that one of these girls might become her friend. भोली जो है दूसरी लड़कियों को देखकर खुश क्यों हो गई? भोली को लगा कि इसमें से कोई उसकी दोस्त बन जाए आगे. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls, but भोली could understand nothing. As we know, भोली was a backward child. Brain injury when she was 8 months old had made her backward. She looked at the pictures on the wall. The colors fascinated her. मतलब भोली को कुछ पढ़ाई समझ में नहीं आ रहा था, लेकिन क्लासरूम के वॉल्स पे जो पिक्चर्स लगे थे वो उसको बहुत सुंदर लगा. She looked at the pictures on the wall. The colors fascinated her. So though Bholi did not understand what the teacher was teaching, what she liked was the colorful pictures on the wall. The colors fascinated her. The horse was brown, just like the horse on which the tehsildar had come to visit their village, who had come to inaugurate the village school. The tehsildar. The school in which Bholi is presently studying, that is the new school which was opened just a few months ago, and the tehsildar had come, and the tehsildar had come on a brown horse. So classroom wall par jo horse laga hua tha, horse ka picture, wo bhi bilkul usi color ka tha. The color of the horse was the same as the horse of the tehsildar. Now, just like the horse on which the tehsildar had come to visit their village. The goat was black, just like the goat of the neighbor. Bholi ko wo sare pictures ekdam original, realistic lage. Horse ka color ekdam original horse ke tarah. The color of the goat was just like an original goat. The parrot was green like the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard. Orchard means fruit garden. So Bholi was not able to understand what the teacher was teaching, but what she liked was the colorful realistic pictures on the wall. The pictures that were pasted on the wall, they looked so real. Horse looked like a real horse. The color of the goat was like a real goat. The color of the parrot was like a real parrot. And had seen in the mango orchard. Parrots jo hai waise hi dikh rahe the. The parrots were looking just like the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard. And the cow was just like their Lakshmi. What about the cow? The cow was just like the... just like her own cow Lakshmi. So pictures, very very realistic, genuine pictures. And suddenly Bholi noticed that the teacher was standing by her side smiling at her. So Bholi was very unfortunate, backward child, not beautiful, neglected by her parents. But one thing she was fortunate, she got a good teacher. The teacher came by her side and smiled at her. The teacher was smiling at her. What is your name, little one? Teacher ne bahut pyar se Bholi se pucha. What And we know that Bholi is stammering. Bholi haklati thi. Wo ek bar mein ek word bhi nahi bol pati thi. Wo jo hai nahi bol pai apna naam. Aadhe mein hi atak gayi. Bho, bho, bho. Then she began to cry, and tears flowed down from her eyes in a helpless flood. And Bholi became very sad. How unfortunate she is. She is not even able to pronounce her name. She began to cry, and tears flowed from her eyes in a helpless flood. She kept her head down as she sat in her corner, not daring to look up at the girls who she knew were still laughing at her. And she began to cry because she was not able to pronounce even her name. Very natural. She began to cry and tears flowed from her eyes in a helpless flood. She kept her head down as she sat down in her corner, not daring to look up at the girls who she knew were still laughing at her. And the children in the school also were very insensitive. Unko bhi Bholi se koi khas sympathy nahi thi. Bholi was a stranger to them. And they also started laughing. And what did Bholi do? She put her head down and she sat in the corner. Bholi did not have the courage to look at the children also, not daring to look up at the girls. So the first experience of Bholi at the school was very sad one. Teacher asked her name, but she was not able to tell her name. She got stuck up midway in her name. And other girls started laughing at her. और टीचर ने नाम पूछा, वो अपना नाम भी नहीं बता पाई पूरे से, और बाकी बच्चे हंसने लगे भोली पर, and भोली started crying. When the school bell rang, all the girls scurried out of the classroom. Scurried means ran out quickly. So bell rang, school was over, all the girls hurried out of the classroom, but Bholi dared not leave her corner. What about Bholi? सारे बच्चे कमरे से बाहर निकल गए और Bholi अपना सर नीचे के वहीं खड़ी थी. Her head still lowered. She kept on sobbing. Bholi was still crying. She felt so insulted, humiliated. She stammered, and the other girls, they laughed at her. And Bholi was still sobbing. Bholi, the teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. Okay. Sobbing. Sobbing means crying. So she kept on sobbing. Still lowered. So Bholi was very embarrassed. She felt very humiliated. कितना हो गया? 40, 40. एक मिनट. The teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. So, but the teacher was very sympathetic to Bholi. She comforted her. When Bholi started crying, the teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. So teacher comforted Bholi when she started crying. She consoled her, soft and soothing. In all her life, she had never been called like that. So this was a unique experience for Bholi. Even at house, she was neglected by her parents. She was scolded all the time. Now the first time in her life, someone is showing Bholi love and sympathy. So she felt very good at that time. It touched her heart. No one had talked to her so politely. No one had expressed so much of love for her. So this was the first time in Bholi's life that someone expressed love for her and get upset the teacher. It was not a command. It touched her heart. So what touched Bholi's heart? Can you hear me? What touched Bholi's heart? The love, kindness, and sympathy that was shown by the teacher. What touched Bholi's heart? The love, kindness, and sympathy that was shown by the teacher. Get up,
the way the teacher talks to Goli touch Goli's heart.
Yes, the way the teacher talked, the way she behaved with her so kindly, expressing so much of love, so much of sympathy. She consoled her, comforted her, talked to her with love, and all this touched Bholi's heart. Because at home, no one showed love for her. Even her parents, they thought of her as a burden. So she felt very touched. Get up, said the teacher. It was not a command. Teacher told her to get up, lekin wo order nahi tha. Ekdam pyar se. प्यार से उसको उठने के लिए बोला, बट जस्ट अ फ्रेंडली सजेशन. सो द टीचर डिड नॉट गिव ऑर्डर्स टू हर, शी वेरी पोलाइटली काइंडली टोल्ड हर टू गेट अप एंड भोली ओबेड हर टीचर. नाउ टेल मी योर नेम. फिर टीचर ने नाम पूछा उससे. अभी तो कोई नहीं था, तो उसने सोचा, टीचर थॉट दैट नाउ भोली विल रिप्लाई कॉन्फिडेंटली. Sweat broke out over her whole body. Again, Bholi started sweating because of nervousness. फिर अगर वो हकलाने लगी, फिर अगर वो नाम नहीं बोल पाई, तो पूरा बॉडी जो है वो पसीना से भर गया, डर से, नर्वसनेस से. Would her stammering tongue again disgrace her? Disgrace means humiliate. Again, what will happen? Will she be disgraced, humiliated because of her stammering? Okay, I will end the class now. We'll continue tomorrow.
Thank you, ma'am, for repeating, and bye.
Okay, bye all of you.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay. Bye, ma'am. I'm here to teach you only some students give any response. Bar bar. मैं तो तैयार ही रहती हूँ. Okay.